This is how we deliver health care to millions of people over the world. In the 1880s, cycling became a major phenomenon in Europe. This is how we deliver health care to millions of people over the world. The gap between rich and poor is not decreasing rapidly as expected.
No more than 4 people can be in the lab at once. I can't attend the lecture because I have a doctor's appointment.
The study of archaeology requires extensive international fieldwork.
The first person in space was from the Soviet Union.
I didn't attend yesterday's lecture. Can I borrow your notes? Basketball was created in 1891 by a physician and a physical instructor. Elephant is the largest land-living mammal.
I used to have a cup of coffee with 1 sugar. There is limited funding in this department to support qualified students.
You and Susan plan to watch a movie tonight. You're at work but have a headache, so you think you might have caught a cold and won't be able to make it to the movie. What would you say to Susan?
You witness a hit-and-run accident on your way home from work. As the only witness, you have crucial information about the vehicle and driver involved. What would you say when reporting the incident to the police?
You and your child have been planning a camping trip over the weekend. However, on the day of departure, the weather forecast predicts heavy rain and thunderstorms. What would you say to your child?
After eating at a restaurant, the manager asks for your feedback. You thought the food was good, but the service was really slow, and they messed up your coffee order. What would you say to the manager?
What is the name of the punctuation mark that shows the end of a sentence?
What is the term for two siblings who are born from one mother at the same time?
What is the name of the story you write about yourself? Which part of the body controls your thoughts?
If the temperature is falling, is it increasing or decreasing?
Most people think of astronomers as people who spend their time in cold observatories peering through telescopes every night. In fact, a typical astronomer spends most of his or her time analyzing data and may only be at the telescope a few weeks of the year. Some astronomers work on purely theoretical problems and never use a telescope at all. You might not know how rarely images are viewed directly through telescopes. The most common way to observe the skies is to photograph them. The process is very simple. First, a photographic plate is coated with a light-sensitive material. The plate is positioned so that the image received by the telescope is recorded on it. Then the image can be developed, enlarged, and published so that many people can study it, because most astronomical objects are very remote. The light we receive from them is rather feeble, but by using a telescope as a camera, long-time exposures can be made. In this way, objects can be photographed that is 100 times too faint to be seen by just looking through a telescope. Natural resources are everything created by the nature on this earth and given to us as the God gift for the easy survival of life here. The progress of whole human fraternity worldwide depends on the different natural resources in various means. However, human beings are using natural resources in wrong ways, which surely lead us to suffer from the total lack of all natural resources in the future. We are only using the resources for fulfilling our various needs without regenerating them back. Natural resources like water, trees, woods, soil, coal, electricity, oil, gas, nuclear energy, minerals, vegetation, wildlife, etc. are very necessary for the proper development of any nation. Natural resources are a form of energy or matter fulfills the needs of people in various aspects like physiological, cultural, socio-economic, etc. All the natural resources benefit us in various means of life as well as play great roles in maintaining the ecological balance all over the planet. Natural resources are of two types named as renewable resources and non-renewable resources. The resources which can get back by the natural cycles are called as renewable resources. However, resources which cannot get back again by the natural processes are called as the non-renewable resources. Renewable resources can be reproduced as they get utilized, such as fish, water, forests, woods, crops, leather, soil, solar energy, wood products, etc. Non-renewable resources are limited and cannot be reproduced, such as metals, like iron, zinc, copper, etc., fossil fuels, like coal, oil deposits, etc., minerals, salts, like phosphates, carbonates, nitrates, etc., stone and many more. Once we lose the non-renewable resources in our life, we cannot get it back as it is gone forever. All such types of natural resources are very necessary to make our life possible on Earth. So, we should try our best to preserve and conserve both natural resources.
When citizens with higher incomes arrive to an already existing urban area, causing an increase in the value of properties and the rise in housing prices, it is said that there is gentrification. Moreover, these changes produce modifications in the area's nature and traditions. These circumstances can bring benefits to particular districts, such as a decrease in crime rates, more investment in infrastructure, and a greater flow in the local economy. Sadly, however, sometimes the original inhabitants are not able to enjoy the new benefits and thus feel left out. In the United States, for instance, gentrification has been a source of conflict in some cities due to racial issues that come up, or because original poor residents end up being displaced since they can't afford the continuously rising rents. The early Arabs worshipped many gods, including the moon god and his wife, the sun goddess. In the 7th century CE, Arab tribes were united by the prophet Muhammad, who preached a new religion, Islam, based on the worship of a single god, Allah. Muslims believed that Muhammad regularly received messages from Allah through the angel Gabriel. Muhammad's followers wrote down these messages in a sacred book called the Quran, meaning recitation. This edition of the Quran uses the earliest form of Arabic script, known as Kufic, which has straight lines and sharp angles. After Muhammad's death, and spurred on by their faith, Arab armies conquered an empire stretching from Spain to India, creating a new civilization.
The UK has a world-class higher education system, the strength of which is, at least in part, the result of the huge diversity of universities, of all sizes and specialisms. Many students deliberately choose to study in a smaller or more specialist institution because of the world-class facilities as well as the safer and more personalized experience that they will receive, and these opportunities should be available to the many international students wanting to study in the UK.
For centuries, astronomers have watched the storm spin across the giant world's face. But for planetary scientists, Jupiter's most distinctive mystery may be what's called the energy crisis of its upper atmosphere. How do temperatures average about as warm as Earth's, even though the enormous planet is more than 5 times further away from the Sun? All the Sun's giant planets display this energy crisis, and those in chilly orbits around other stars probably have it too.
I want to explore certain issues with you. There is no conclusion to my talk. There is no closure. I think over time, throughout history, cities have changed in whether they were strategic spaces or routinized spaces. They're not always strategic. This, our global modernity, is a time when cities are strategic. That doesn't mean all cities, but that means that certain cities, but throughout the world, become spaces where our most acute problems, our major governance challenges, hit the ground, become concrete, become urgent. The city, urban space, has a capacity to pull down a lot of stuff that otherwise stays up there. Take the environmental question. National states can talk and talk and talk for years. Kyoto took years. But in the meantime, cities had to deal with the environmental question.
Lecture and answer the questions. Now let's talk about tests and grades. There will be two written tests and one oral test this semester. Each written test will have 40 multiple choice questions. The oral test will have 5 questions. Some of you may think the tests are too difficult with too many questions, but that is not. So as a matter of fact, there will be a summary handout every class this semester. And if you study them, well, then the tests will be very easy. And speaking about grades, the written and oral tests will be just a small portion of your final grade. Active class participation is the most important thing to get a good grade. So please listen to my lectures carefully. Ask many questions and discuss the topics with your classmates and me during the class. It will be very good for you to prepare for each unit before class 2. Are you going to be more effective and happy as a specialist or as a generalist? Do you find real satisfaction in the precision, order, and system of a clearly laid out job? Or are you one of those people who tend to grow impatient with anything that looks like a routine job? There are great many careers in which the emphasis is on specialization. You find these careers in engineering and in accounting, in production, in statistical work, and in teaching. But there is an increasing demand for people who are able to take in a great area at a glance. There is, in other words, a demand for people who are capable of seeing the forest rather than the trees of making overall.
The new Yankee Stadium has opened in the Bronx. I went to a game Saturday, and it's a much friendlier place for anyone trying to eat healthfully and maintain some environmental awareness. When I entered the park, I stopped at the produce stand, and bought a couple of fresh pears. Later, I went to the noodle bowl stand, where for $8.50, I got a bowl of noodles, veggies, and tofu. Tofu at the ballpark. The snack was listed on the menu board at 240 calories. All the food choices have calorie counts posted now, so you can avoid or still indulge in the almost 1,100 calorie Moe's Home Wrecker Burrito at La Esquina Latina. I also had a caramel apple, which, as junk food goes, is still pretty good. Every few yards, you find a trio of disposal cans for regular trash, plastic, and compost, which you may actually have items for with a produce stand on site, and which may eventually foster a garden in which more fresh vegetables take root for the home team.
Open a newspaper any day of the week and you're likely to read about a promising new treatment for one disease or another. But according to a study published in the September 5th issue of Science, it can take decades for those cures to make it to the clinic. Researchers from the U.S. and Greece combed through the scientific literature to see how long it actually takes for compounds that look good in a laboratory to get through clinical trials and get used on patients. The scientists focused their attention on a handful of interventions that were widely hailed as being clinically effective. And they found that, for the average drug, the time that elapsed between its initial discovery and the first paper to show its clinical effectiveness was about 24 years. Some drugs moved much faster. One of the protease inhibitors used to treat HIV made it from patenting through clinical trials in only 4 years. Maybe that's because the team studying that drug included experts in both basic and clinical sciences. The researchers say that such multidisciplinary efforts could help future treatments get to the clinic sooner. In the meantime, they note, scientists should avoid making promises about quick cures.
Avoid confusing the cause and effect of these changes.
Animals raised in captivity behave differently from their wild counterparts.
Many graduates studying journalism get jobs in the communications field. An aerial photograph was promptly registered for further evaluation.